Hi everyone, you are on How to Fix It. This video guide contains all the steps for the disassembly and reassembly of the game console and applying liquid metal to the PS4 Pro processor chip. What you need for the disassembly of the PlayStation 4 Pro: Torx T8 screwdriver with a hole inside, and Phillips 1 screwdriver. Plastic pry tools. Tweezers. Liquid metal and liquid insulating adhesive. The PlayStation 4 has a lot of screws of different sizes, and it is very important to screw them in the right places. I recommend using a magnetic mat and keeping track of each screw step by step. This will help to reassemble your game console successfully, and don't worry about losing any of the screws. All of them will definitely remain on the magnetic mat. In the description, I left links where to buy all the necessary tools. Also, in the description, I left a link to a video where I test the effectiveness of liquid metal in PS4 Pro and thermal paste. This video will be of interest to owners of the first generation PS4 Pro. This is the first generation of PS4 Pro, model CUH7016. If your PS4 Pro second generation, like a CUH7216, to this video guide, I left a link in the description. Let's start disassembling the PS4 Pro. Remove the plastic cover over the hard drive. Use a Phillips 1 screwdriver to remove one screw. Then remove the hard drive. Remove the warranty seal. Then, using a Torx T8 screwdriver, remove the three screws. PS4 Pro CUH7100 series only has one warranty seal and one screw. Now, nothing prevents you from removing the bottom cover. On the back of the device, you need to grab the two corners with your fingertips and pull up until you hear a loud click. Now slide the cover back and remove it. Remove the two screws that hold the power supply in place. Remove the top cover in the same way as the bottom cover. Grip the cover on the corner and just pull up until it clicks. Then, when you are sure the cover is off, slide the cover back. Use a Torx T8 screwdriver to remove five screws from the power supply. Remove the power supply by pulling it up, but be careful not to pull too far. The power supply is still connected with one cable. Grip the connector on the power supply and pull it out. Disconnect all ribbon cables and antenna cables from the main board. Remove all screws on the metal plate. On the back side of the metal plate, there are thermal pads from VRAM chips. Do not lose them. Please note, it is necessary to remove the screws evenly on each side, with a few turns of each screw. Grip the edge of the motherboard and slowly lift it upwards from the game console housing. Remove the thermal paste from APU and heatsink. Use isopropyl alcohol to degrease the surface of the APU and heatsink. This must be done before applying the liquid insulating adhesive. The PS4 Pro processor has SMD components that need to be isolated from accidental contact with liquid metal. Otherwise, if the liquid metal gets on the SMD component, a short circuit will occur, causing the PS4 to fail. To insulate the SMD components, I will use liquid insulating adhesive. The liquid electrical tape must have two important properties: resistance to high temperatures and electrical insulation. How to insulate a PS4 processor chip? Apply liquid insulation adhesive only on SMD components. Wipe off excess insulation from the chip surface. After, leave it to dry for about 40 minutes. As a result, you get an insulated surface, and now the processor chip is ready for applying liquid metal. How to apply liquid metal to PS4 processor chip? Set the microchip onto the syringe and carefully apply a pinhead-sized drop of liquid metal on the chip. If you've applied a little more liquid metal, you can remove excess material with the absorber tip. Spread liquid metal with the supplied cotton swab. An increased contact pressure of the cotton swab can facilitate the application of the liquid metal over the surface of the processor chip. After the chip is done, do the same with the heatsink. installing the motherboard, make sure that the power supply cable goes into this hole. Please note, do not over-tighten the screws to avoid damaging the APU chip. Tighten the screws evenly on each side with a few turns of each screw.
Thank you.
I really appreciate you watching my video guides. You can ask all additional questions regarding the repair in the comments. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.